This Tuesday on Lifetime, Valerie Bertinelli stars in a Lifetime original movie.
You said you were going to cure my cancer, but all you did was rape me. I'm starting to think I don't have cancer at all.
Well, you're right about the rape part, but I'm sorry, you still do have cancer.
Brian, did you know that Daryl Hannah has one wooden finger?
Really? Where'd you read that?
In Piopple magazine.
Huh. Jillian, can you run and get me a beer from the kitchen?
Oh, yeah, sure, no problem.
Big plans tonight?
Yeah, Brian's taking me to Disney on Ice.
Aw, I want to go.
Well, Peter, if you want, you can have my ticket.
I'm gonna go put on my Donald Duck costume. Ready?
Hey, Peter, what's with the hat?
I'm pretending to be a veteran.
What?
Guys, you could be veterans, too. Look what happens when I put on sunglasses.
Wow.
I want to try.
Do I need to remind you I actually am a veteran? And I'm sickened by the thought of trolling for free handouts on account of being a vet, much less pretending to be one.
What if I told you your glasses do playing with the boys?
Go ahead, give it a whirl.
The Iowa Double Tape Deck. The Waldorf and Statler of every thrift store.
The selection here stinks.
Yeah, and so do the customers.
Jim Henson died of treatable pneumonia.
They have the magic girl power jeans.
Holy crap, what happened? I think I turned into America Ferrera. Someone help!
Looking passable, Stewie. Looking damn passable.
Oh, crap. People we know. You know the drill. We're donating, not buying. Just doing our part to give back to the community.
Thank you for your service.
Huh?
My father's a veteran, too. Thank you for protecting us and for posting revenge porn on Marine Corps message boards.
Actually, I'm not...
I'm going to start a trend of interrupting your sentences.
Well, no, it's just a hat. I didn't
think... Thank you for your service.
Bless you and all of our veterans.
Oh, gosh, I'm not really a
I don't have time to hear the rest of your sentence, but thank you for being a veteran because you're definitely a veteran.
Feels real good to be a veteran. Even better than buying a bottle of Newman's Own.
This makes me a good person.
Someone just bought a bottle of bland salad dressing. Now we can use all proceeds to do jihad stuff.
Why do you still read the newspaper? Nobody does that anymore.
I like to keep up on local news. Huh. Most of these arrests are Cleveland, and the arresting officer is Joe Swanson.
Can I help you, sir?
I'm doing my mail route, Joe.
Maybe you'd be more comfortable talking about it down at the station.
It is more comfortable here.
The police station. Come for the racial profiling. Stay for the comfort.
I thought you were spending the day with Jillian.
I was, but Peter took her off my hands. Perfect timing. I've been feeling a little smothered lately. Plus, it's given me a chance to work on my novel. And I finally have a title.
What is it?
Faster Than the Speed of Love.
That is the worst title I've ever heard.
No, it's the story of a boy who has to rescue his father, who's a pilot that's been taken captive by a militant Islamic country.
That's the movie Iron Eagle.
What? Is that a recent film?
They made three sequels.
Yeah, well, in mine, the boy's got to gather all these old World War II pilots to help him rescue his father.
That's one of the sequels!
Well, in mine, one of the World War II guys is Japanese, but they accept him anyway.
I'm gonna pee my pants!
Is that you?
Oh, yeah. A friend invited me to this charity ball.
A friend? She's 100!
Older women are cultured, worldly. I've got nothing to be defensive about. Her husband passed away. She appreciates my friendship.
I don't like it.
I need you to mow the lawn. It's out of control.
I can't mow the lawn, Lois. The Friends of Distinction are out there, grazing in the grass.
Baby. Oh, let me get in on that! Where'd they go?
Cleveland? You okay in there?
Is that a diamond-encrusted watch fob?
This? Oh, yeah, I've had this.
Nobody's owned one of those for 80 years!
What are you up to?
You already did this.
I'm not trying to show skepticism. My head is too heavy. I heard the doctor whisper to Lois, 3,000th percentile.
Sure is fun hanging out with you, Peter.
That means thank you in my new language I'm inventing. Anyway, all I was saying is, if you think about it, it shouldn't have been Ferris Bueller's Day Off. It should have been Ferris Bueller's Day On.
Yeah! And he was so on that day, so it kind of works on two levels.
Well, I don't know what you mean by that, but how about that Cameron, huh?
Oh, definitely.
I don't know when the hell Brian is going to open his eyes and get serious with you.
I really wish he would. It'd be so great if we were at least living together.
Well, you need to just lay it on the line with him. Either he commits to you or you're gone.
What the hell did you do? Leave me alone. It's all your fault that Jillian's gone.
You let the fat man talk you into moving out. You let Jillian walk out the door. Stop getting pushed around. Be a man. If you want her, go get her.
You are absolutely right. It is time for me to take charge of my own life.
You're too late. I met someone else.
Jillian, do you get the oxygen network?
If I miss my Moesha, I get a bit crabby.
As a veteran, I get to star in a viral YouTube video of me reuniting with my beloved pet. My pet is Christian the Lion. This is my heterosexual roommate, Ace, with whom I shared the lion 2 decades ago. I have a family now!
You guys aren't veterans at all. You're frauds.
Okay, we ain't real vets.
You're under arrest.
What? Why?
You three are in violation of the Stolen Valor Act, which makes it a crime to pretend to be a veteran.
Oh, so suddenly it's a crime to break the law? You're not gonna throw a veteran in jail.
Is this some kind of joke to you?
No, it was a sincere idea.
Only on the condition that you men enlist in the military for real.
Well, I'm off.
Oh, Peter, I'm so worried. Where are they stationing you?
I can't tell you. That is on a need-the-dough basis.
Florida?
Shh.
Hey, you be safe.
Before you go, can you teach me to shave?
Well, for starters, bud, that's supposed to be on your pubes. You got a secret inch hiding under there.
This is what I'm gonna be missing.
Guys?
We're over here painting clever names on boats. No, Peter. It's supposed to be Short and Poppy.
I told you, I'm not Aquaman. I am the Submariner.
What's your deal?
I'm just like Aquaman, but I can't get fish to do things.
That's the big thing.
I mean, isn't that all Aquaman does?
No, he can also breathe underwater, and he's strong, like me.
Hey, Aquaman!
Yeah.
Hey, make a fish do something.
Oh, shucks, guys. I don't know.
Wow, a real superhero.
I have little wings on my feet.
It's over.
I'm going home.
What? Why?
Because I'm sick of this. I'm the only one taking the job seriously.
Gotta steal that kid's jet ski. It's the only way, guys.
Peter, we're now literally standing on the boat. That's how close the boat is.
Made it.
You wanted to ride the jet ski.
I wanted to ride the jet ski. U.S. Coast Guard. Ah, crap, we're gonna die.
Freeze.
I'm so happy you're back home where you belong, Peter. It's just not the same here without you.
Thanks, Lois. And I thought about you not at all. Now, to start the mower, you grab this pull cord like so and give it a nice hard yank.
Can I change my grip? It's a more familiar motion.
For the rest, you can just watch this how-to video on YouTube.
What's going on, guys? I'm Corey, here to take your lawn mowing skills to the next level.
Did you know Corey got recruited by ISIS? He disappeared, and now there's this guy doing ISIS videos, and they think it's Corey.
Salam alaikum, guys. This is Corey, here to talk about making a dirty bomb with stuff you can find in your kitchen.
You can bring your friend over there to help you. Come on, Herbert. Rope this calf.
We like to October in Zurich.
Ah, yes, the best place to October. The secret, however, is to October in Zurich, but in September, to avoid the obnoxious Octobering crowds. Saving October for Paris, Novembering there, then Decembering in Palm Beach in November, and in December, Januarying, of course, as always, in Gstaad.
We December in London.
You, madame, are a cream-faced loon.
I don't believe you've met the Admiral.
Well, he may be an admiral, but he's certainly not admirable. Panty drop, swoon,
oh!
Commercial. Is that medal a stretched-out carnival penny?
Thank you for noticing, Count. It means a lot from a man whose top hat looks suspiciously like an Amazon Echo with a cardboard brim.
Why? What a preposterous notion!
Alexa?
No, don't say that!
Maybe we could even help each other.
Exactly! Two con men like us working together, we'll be set like a passive-aggressive alarm clock.
I don't know if you've noticed, but the sun's been up for like an hour. No, you don't have to get up. Let your wife do everything. Just keep sleeping. You're a good husband. I'm sure she doesn't fantasize about your contractor who's already downstairs working on... Well, I can't really figure out what he's working on. Oh, I know. Your wife.
Jillian's gone.
Look, Brian, I know you're upset now, but I think it's important to see things in perspective. Remember when Alex P. Keaton lost his girlfriend, and then he got another one, and everything was all right?
And then he got Parkinson's. Yikes.
That's just the kind of can-do spirit that built this nation.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
Except the Jews.
Franklin, for the fifth time, I'm sorry you overpaid for your house, but it's not going in.
You'll be sorry.
Noted. Moving on.
You like that?
Yeah, it's rad!
Don't talk, please. Hang on, let me get a condom.
Brian, are you guys up?
No, Stewie, go away!
Brian, don't be mean to him.
Yes, Brian, if you're mean to me, I'll stop paying the rent. I'm paying Mr. Lickety-Self's half of the rent.
Is that true?
All right, yes, fine, it's true. God knows I didn't want to.
Wait, you didn't want to move in with me? Oh my God, I've never felt so stupid.
Really?
I don't want to be your guilty burden, Brian. We're through.
I'm sorry, Brian. You'll feel better in the morning. Hey, you know what you should do? You should have sex with somebody else just to get back at her for walking out on you. Just have sex with somebody. Anybody. Just don't even think about it. The next person you see. The very next person you see. Come on, time for you to meet some women who are gonna make you forget about Jillian.
Looks like there's a lot of gay guys here.
Yeah, everybody's having a good time.
Want to introduce you to Joanna. Look out for this one. She's a bit of a car.
What food can't make up its mind?
Oh, this is gonna be good.
A waffle.
Oh, this one. Didn't I warn you? Right? How are you still single?
I'm Peter, sir.
You're big for your age, ain't you, Petey?
Yeah.
Why, what's this? It wasn't a trick. It was stuck to your neck.
Oh, yeah. Sometimes I fall asleep on candy.
The holy grail for guys like us.
Who is she?
Margaret Woolworth Carrington von Schumacher Chanel Astor Livingston Comte de Saint-Exupéry Mountbatten Windsor Armani Roosevelt von Trapp Wickenham Hearst Montgomery Rothschild Johnson & Johnson Twillsworth Dolce Gabbana von Zweiger 2nd Montgomery De La Roche Geico Vanderbilt Lannister Van Buren Butterworth How I Met Your Mother Wrigley Louise Dreyfus Ludwig Morgan Stanley Dumont Lamborghini Forbes Higby Winthrop Chanel Remy Martin Fitzwilliam Kennedy Motel 6 Fairchild Brooke Pritzker Davenport von Stolen Monty Python Ellisworth Aston Martin Haverbrook Ziff Lauder Hilton DuPont, Kincaid, Winslow, Coors, Oviatt, Marlborough, Pembroke, Huffington, Bush, Mellon, Sinclair, Mellencamp, Starbucks, Van Dyke, 3rd, Montgomery, Marriott, Barrington, Chadsworth, Big League Chew, Chesterfield, Kensington, Booth, Bishop, Longbottom, Nottingham, Meisterburger, Burgermeister, Tudor, Habsburg, Rockefeller, Onassis.
You mean the heir to the Woolworth, Carrington, von Schumacher, Chanel, Astor, Livingston, Comte, de Saint-Exupéry, Mountbatten, Windsor, Armani, Roosevelt, von Trapp, Wickenham, Hearst, Montgomery, Rothschild, Johnson & Johnson, Twillsworth, Dolce Gabbana, von Zweiger, 2nd Montgomery, De La Roche, Geico, Vanderbilt, Lannister, Van Buren, Butterworth, How I Met Your Mother, Wrigley, Louise, Dreyfus, Ludwig, Morgan, Stanley, Dumont, Lamborghini, Forbes, Higby, Winthrop, Chanel, Remy Martin, Fitzwilliam, Kennedy Motel 6, Fairchild, Brooke Pritzker, Davenport, von Stolen, Monty Python, Ellisworth, Aston Martin, Haverbrook, Ziff Lauder, Hilton, Dupont, Kincaid, Winslow, Coors, Oviatt, Marlborough, Pembroke, Huffington, Bush, Mellon, Sinclair, Mellencamp, Starbucks, Van Dyke, 3rd Montgomery, Marriott, Barrington, Chadsworth, Big League Chew, Chesterfield, Kensington, Booth, Bishop, Longbottom, Nottingham, Meisterburger, Burgermeister, Tudor, Habsburg, Rockefeller, Onassis, Fortune?
Exactly. If we can charm her, we'll be set for life. No more scraping and scavenging like a laughing hyena.
I don't sound desperate, but I'm very desperate. I'm not a very capable predator. My family's back at the den waiting for me. I think this is the day I starve to death. Just kidding, I have no family.
Is that a cat's protective league pin on your lapel?
I like this party.
Pussies?
Cock? Get the hell out of my face, Brian!
Quagmire?
No, Quagmire!
That's what I said.
Oh, sorry, I didn't hear you because of the prosthetics.
I've got no chance, have I? A tertiary character like me.
You most certainly do not. I don't even think we're going to give you the dance you rehearsed. If you can help me wrap this up, if you know what I mean, I'll split the estate with you two. But unless you're prepared to kill her, get the hell out!
Happy birthday, dear Margaret Woolworth, Comte de Saint-Exupéry.
I'm just gonna hang here for a minute.
It's time you did all the work and I goof off with Mr. Herbert!
Like hell it is!
Why are you being such a jerk, Dad?
Dad!
Well, he often said he wanted to explode all over me.
Good Quahog evening. Oh, let's do that again. Good evening, Hog Quo, I'm Tucker Tom. Good after evening noon, Hog Tom, Quo, I'm Er Tuck. Quo, goodning noon, Tom Er Tuck, I'm Ning Ning after evening, Quo, noon hog. Our top story, Newport's wealthiest heiress, Margaret Woolworth, holy God, I'm not reading all that, was found dead in her home of an apparent heart attack.
We're rich, Stewie, and no flip joke can take that away.
Miss Woolworth, et cetera, died owing $18 million, for which you are now liable.
That's right. It was a mixed story.
I say, Brian, look. Three rows down.
What?
Is that Tom Bosley?
What would Tom Bosley be doing on a train in Switzerland?
I'm almost certain.
Tom!
Did he look?
I don't know.
Well, if I yell, you have to watch.
Tom Bosley! No, it's not him.
Huh.
Attention, delegates. This session of the United Nations is hereby convened.
Man, this sucks. Hey, podium guy! Hey, I got a problem here.
Excuse me, some of us are here to learn.
No one's talking to you, Albania.
Is there a problem back there?
You bet your funny accent there's a problem. I'm stuck up here in the nosebleeds. I am president of Pretoria. I want a better...
Yeah, and I served honorably as a UN interpreter.
Okay, he's mad about something. He appears to be talking really fast. He spits whenever he makes the ch noise, which in this language happens a lot. I'm expected to entertain him and his wife tonight, so if anyone knows a good restaurant in the area, sushi or tapas, something where they're always bringing stuff to the table so you have something to talk about, you know? Hey, what's this? This looks good. That's it.
War! Oh, war! War! That last sentence was about war!
I won, everyone! I won! Other kids, Stewie lost, and he deserves our ridicule!
Hey, whoa, wait!
And there was a weird cucumber thing!
That son of a bitch! Come back here!
Oh, you can do it, Stewie, for sure. Free your foot, and together we will bump wieners.
But it's stuck, Norwegian mid-level model girlfriend.
Oh, just untie your shoe is how.
Oh, duh.
Stewie, when will you free me from this thought bubble hell?
Not for a while. I may need you if I run for office.
It was awfully nice of our new neighbors to invite us over for dinner.
I don't know, Lois. Going to Cleveland's house with someone else living there just seems weird. Like when a new pope moves into the Vatican.
Hi, I don't know who to complain to about this, but I'm still getting XVIII's mail. Yeah, no, he's not here anymore. This is XXIV. Yeah, no, I don't need Newsweek. No, I don't need National Geographic. We'll hang on to Boys Life.
Wow, I can use smoking to get out of anything! Finally, I'm above the law. Like my 14th century ancestor, King of Denmark, Griffin. More wine! More women! More table! I'm having a heart attack! Is anyone at the table a doctor?
I am!
Come here! Hurry! Run!
But the very faraway doctor couldn't make it in time, and that's why here in Denmark, we have very small tables.
Oh, my muffins are ready.
You made muffins?
Well, it wasn't the muffin fairy. Or was it? Go ahead, try it.
Peter.
Try it.
Dad, I think Mom's right. Maybe you should go back to that doctor.
Well, now, wait a minute, Meg. Let's not be too hasty. These are delicious. What's the secret ingredient?
Spoojizicum.
Oh, ew.
What? Oh, you thought, no. Spoojizicum. It's a sugar substitute from the Czech Republic. That's right, Spoojizicum. Drovos Njozni.
Ever heard of Bono? He says he knows you.
Daddy, what the hell are you doing? You throw Peter in jail?
Hey, pumpkin, welcome. Whatever you do, don't tell them you have a clitoris.
Yeah, they told me that at the embassy. Look, I'm sorry you got swindled, but you can't treat people this way. You let Peter out of that jail right now. And give these people back their health clinic and their school.
No!
Hi, Lois. I like your shorts. Bye, Lois.
Oh, my God! Enough is enough. That's your son-in-law. And my husband.
I know how families work, Lois. All right. Let him go!
Yay! Lois, how much was your flight and which card did you put it on?
Wow, then it must have been hard for him to accept when you were paralyzed.
That's just it. My dad doesn't know I'm handicapped. I never told him. I never told him!
Oh, Joe, don't cry. It's gonna make me cry. Ah! I cry like Snoopy! Ah!
God, it's like I'm the only person in the house who gets social media.
That'll get it started.
Your dog wrote an insensitive tweet. You can't eat here.
Uh-oh, Meg. It's a sensitivity mob.
It was just a joke.
There's no such thing as jokes anymore.
Yeah, we live in a post-joke world.
Chris, maybe we should just eat outside?
No, Meg, we're eating here.
I'd like to see you try.
Hi, I'd like to be an Uber driver.
Okay, sure. Welcome aboard.
Don't I need to fill out a form?
Oh, right. Yeah, of course.
Name, Peter Griffin. Criminal history. This section is optional. I will skip this. And done. Here you go.
Yeah, none of this really matters. All I need to know is, do you have a car, a phone, and a face?
It's my dog's car. Oh, and I know you didn't ask, but I am quick to anger.
Okay, great. Now get out there and try to kiss as many ladies as you can. The record is 60 in a month. You, sir, are officially an Uber driver.
Ah!
Wait, how did Joe get halfway up those stairs?
Lois, get in here! It's dark and I'm frightened!
I think they've got this thing backwards. Hey, wake up! I had a bad dream, so now your night has to be terrible.
Peter, Stewie's upset. Scooch over so he can sleep with us.
Oh, come on. Are you serious? Last time he kicked me all night. And I got a big day tomorrow. I got two shows.
All right, folks. Big treat for you today. He's a little shy. Put your hands together for Sham Peter.
I'm not shy. I'm angry. I'm in constant pain. This act has been condemned by over 30 nations. I'm gonna kill you all.
We really gotta figure out a better way to budget for this family's future.
Bitcoin.
What?
I don't know.
This is serious. We need to think about our kids' education. Of course, it's already too late for Meg to go to college, and Chris is too dumb to get in anywhere.
Yay!
No, Chris, not yay.
But there's still time for Stewie. Let's sit down later and see if we can figure out a plan to get our finances in order.
Don't worry about it, Lois. I will always provide for the family, even if I have to shoot our dinner. This'll look great in my study. I'm a hunter, but I'm a silly hunter. Well, I like helping people out. That's why I was such a good breakup rodeo clown.
I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you. I've been sleeping with your sister.
What?!
Hey now, over here, over here, over here, hey now, over here, hey now, over here, over here. Oh, and now that I'm inside the barrel, he gave you and your sister HPV.
I hope you enjoyed your meal, sir. May I offer you a toothpick?
Oh, I don't know, we've already spent a lot of money in here tonight.
No, sir, it's free.
Oh.
Peter, that's not how you use a toothpick. You pick your teeth with it. I cannot believe I have to explain this to you.
There are gaps in my knowledge. This is hardly news. Wow, this is awesome. This is like I'm having a whole second meal. Man, this just feels right. Smitty's Steakhouse. You know, this was the fanciest restaurant in Quahog when I was a kid. The ladies' room has a big space with chairs in it, like a living room, before you get back to where the crappers are.
Good evening and welcome to Smitty's. I'll be back with martinis for Mom and Dad.
Oh, Peter, look, you can put your business card in this bowl and maybe win a free lunch.
I don't have a business card, and I think you knew that.
I hope you enjoyed your meal, sir. May I offer you a toothpick?
Oh, I don't know. We've already spent a lot of money in here tonight.
No, sir. It's free.
Excuse me. We're from out of town. Where do people go to listen to live music around here?
I'll handle this. All right, here's what you're going to do. Skip the live music. Get yourself a room over at the Wickford Marina. Take her out on a balcony, point to any boat in the harbor, and tell her it's yours. Now, you got rubbers? Now that I'm a toothpick guy, I call them rubbers. Or you could just pull the hose out of the bucket and let it spray free.
I've had a vasectomy.
My mom has two jobs. All right, I'm off to the fish market.
What? Why?
Well, the most intimidating people are toothpick guys who work at seafood counters and make people uncomfortable for not knowing about fish.
What's good here?
It's all good.
What's the freshest?
It's all fresh.
How about the halibut? Is it gamey?
Gamey?
I mean, you know, is it fishy?
It's all fish.
Is there a...
I'm gonna need you to put that large two-handed colander over the toilet.
Peter, that was a wedding present from my aunt.
Well, let's use the ice cream maker. We've never used it once.
Calm down. You can always get another toothpick.
Oh, my God, you're right. Lois, we gotta drive to Smitty's right now and get one.
Now? But we told Chris we'd be there when he wakes up from surgery.
All right, we were able...
Just like how Meg ruined broccoli. Hey, Meg, look. They're little trees.
No, they're not.
They're not?
Hey, Peter.
Oh, look, there's Quagmire and his transgendered mother, which is now great.
Hey, Quagmire. Hey, Ida. I didn't know you liked Smitty's.
Oh, yeah, I've been coming here for ages. They even named a sandwich.
Why don't you come over tomorrow? We'll fire up the grill and have the gang over for a cookout.
Well, that sounds wonderful.
Well, great, we'll be there. Hey, before you two leave, let's take a photo.
Yeah, selfie. I just learned that word.
Perfect. Well, good night, you guys.
See you tomorrow.
Glenn, that's very sweet, but you're talking about your best friend's wife.
I know, it's wrong. And Peter's a good friend. Not like Cleveland.
Hey, I got two of these phone books. Didn't know if you wanted one. Hey, how long have we known each other? Long time. And yet we've never discussed mother's maiden names, the names of old pets, high school...
By the way, I couldn't figure out how to use your oven, so I destroyed it in a blind rage. Well, good night.
Oh, after that steak, I gotta go lay down on the toilet.
Looks like I got a couple of messages.
Dad? Dad? Grandpa's going nuts on the oven. Can you come home quick?
What the hell is that? There's one from Quagmire.
For years.
Oh, my God. He's in love with Lois?
Yeah, and if you keep listening, you can hear a Puerto Rican busboy get fired in the background. It's pretty funny. He cries. But can you believe Quagmire?
Well, I guess it's not that shocking. I mean, he has said 100 times that he wants to bang Lois.
No, that's just Quagmire being a horn dog. This is love.
I don't know. I think you're making too big a deal out of this.
Too big? It was purple. I thought it was grape.
Look, you've got to be the bigger man. You got to just keep this to yourself.
Fine, I won't say anything.
Good. And don't be passive-aggressive either, like one of those songs in an old musical.
You're hideous to be without. You're big and fat in the heart.
How blessed are we to have all them boys to man just floating around in the sky.
Glenn, Ida, you made it.
Hey, Lois, I brought the hamburger buns like you wanted. I wasn't sure what people like, so I got some with seeds on them and some without.
What does he mean by that? Seeds? Like semen? Is that what he means? Semen on the buns? Am I the only one hearing this? Get the hell away from my wife, you scumbag! End of cookout. Get out of my house and don't ever speak to me again.
Wow, that turned ugly fast. Just like my trip to Tampa Bay.
Hey, city boy.
But his wife, hell, we've all done that. I've heard. Allegedly. But not often. And never to Donna. Except when she wore those shiny gold shorts to parent-teacher night.
Oh, yeah, that was hilarious.
Yeah, it was so tacky. But if Quagmire actually has feelings for you... I'm afraid he might take you away from me.
Peter, nobody's taking me anywhere.
On you! Shame, shame, shame! Shame on Q! This was serious, but it turned into something fun!
Glenn, is that you?
Oh, yeah, I was just buying a... Oh, sour cream. You wanted me to remind you, sour cream.
Mr. Quagmire, which box do these beads go in?
Let me smell them. They go in the big box.
Quagmire, I can't believe you're moving. Look, give it time.
We now return to Dateline.
Our story tonight, the guy you think did it, he did it. Now go to bed. Your grandkids are coming tomorrow.
I had a pretty good egg dish last night.
What? What am I supposed to do with that? Oh, come on, that ain't true.
Yes, it is. He had all the fun ideas. Remember, he even took me parasailing. This is awesome! It's like I'm flying! I've never felt so alive!
Oh, if only I had a pair of legs. All right!
Now, get in the car.
What? Why?
You'll see.
Why should I trust you? You're always tricking me into going places I don't wanna. Oh, you said we were going to a place Walt Disney built.
No, Peter, I said supported. By the way, don't go on the train ride. And the truth is, we all have private thoughts we don't act on. And that's okay. For instance, every time I'm on the subway, I want to push a stranger onto the tracks, and that's fine. I don't do it.
I guess you're right. I don't totally disagree with what Kim Jong-un's doing, but you don't see me moving there.
I take medicine I get from the veterinarian. Is that one?
No. Do you love PETA enough to repress your love for me?
Peter, if you're willing to forget all about this, I'm more than happy to continue hiding my true feelings.
I do miss us hanging out together. Sorry I kind of went a little crazy.
Ah, that's all right.
Guys, you know that egg dish I was talking about? Turns out that was just a dream I had.
It's that time of year again. Are you a New England dirtbag who wants to run with bulls but thinks Spain is gay? Then don't miss the Seriously Wicked Bull Run in South Attleboro, Mass. You and your friends can run from a bunch of live bulls, and lots of times there's a chick whose boob comes out. Order your tickets before it's too late.
And I'm supposed to mention that I saw you on Living Social.
Was that worth it? Was that worth the $1 you saved?
I'm sorry, we're not doing that promotion anymore.
Oh, all the humiliation, none of the reward.
You know, some people are okay with the drive-through car wash. Me? I'm a fan of the hand job.
We are competing in the International Chef Boyardee Lookalike Contest.
Oh, well, where's your chef hat? You guys are gonna lose, especially Cleveland.
He's in the Cream of Wheat competition, which is down the street. We gotta go now. We're very late.
Well, this is funny because guess where I'm going? And I got the hat. You guys are dead.
That was amazing. Hey, just to be clear, I don't really think you're a whore. I just need to say that to, you know, to finish.
Oh, yeah, of course. And obviously, I don't think you're my Uncle Dale.
Good, same page.
Oh, crap, my husband's home early.
Wait a minute, you're married? And he's here? Now?
Yeah, that's him. You've got to get out of here.
Oh my God, that was close.
Yeah, but think about it. As long as he thinks you're our new pet, we can keep fooling around behind his back.
Huh. You're right. Oh, this could be an even better scam than that claw machine at the arcade.
Damn it, this game is so stupid! It's impossible to do anything with a dumb, crappy claw!
Hey, that's...
We clearly overdressed.
They have the type of fat white woman here that not even I am interested in.
Ladies, gentlemen, and alternative high school graduates, get ready to run for your lives!
Shouldn't have worn high heels.
Look out, Joe!
below my neck. I can't move a muscle, guys.
Oh, my God! Joe's completely paralyzed!
Oh, that's me. That's unfortunate. That's Lois. Hold on. Hey, babe. Good. Little hiccup, but fun.
Could you collect my mail forever? I'm leaving Joe and moving to Europe. I didn't sign up for this.
Buddy, wait! God, this is awful. What am I gonna do?
Well, seems like you folks have this all taken care of.
Surprise!
Oh, you guys! Hey, don't go in that room back there. It's, like, super sad.
Man, this is a pretty sweet gig. Like being a member of Daft Punk.
Look at this old Casio keyboard from the 1980s that I have found. Watch what happens when I push this demo button.
Hello, Daft Punk. Great song. Here's a Grammy.
Oh, ho!
You know he's fun.
You're a good friend, Peter.
Joe, I just wish we could do more, but obviously your mouth is full.
And you probably don't want any reminders of Bonnie around the house, so I cleared out all of her underwear. Okay, don't be a stranger.
Yeah, because we're not supposed to talk to those.
I don't know. I'm not sure I feel right about leaving Joe.
Be cool. This is the guy whose wife I'm banging.
Oh, what a romantic way to put it.
Yeah, it's great. I just pretend to be their dog, and then when he leaves for work, I get to go to the pound, if you know what I mean.
God, Brian, you are such a scumbag. I can't believe you.
Mommy! Mommy! Where's my mommy? I have no one and nothing!
I'm right here, honey.
Oh, thank God.
She's such...
Look, this whole page is all the Wayans brothers sitting in different positions. How you suppose they come up with all them positions? You give me a million years. I just ain't wired that way. Marlon's like a rubber man. He can sit in any kind of way. Here's Keenan telling the younger ones how to sit. Like they gonna listen. Damon's doing his own thing. No surprise there. That's Damon.
Where do you think you're going? You're my dog. You're not going anywhere. Besides, I need you, boy. Now more than ever. I think my wife is cheating on me.
Hey, Tori, it's Brian. I'm getting the Chinese food for us. I think I'm gonna order some me-like bang ho. That's not a real thing. I'm talking about sex. All right, I'll be there in 5.
Quagmire's right. It's too much. I just think he'd be better off under the care of grumpy Filipino nurses.
Yeah, that's why I looked into it, and we've reserved a place for him at the state home for mentals and bastards.
Oh my God, sometimes they whip him with hoses. Outside? This is perfect! Yeah.
Wasn't it great?
I thought it was stupid. Take care, Joe.
You know, that state home we left Joe in didn't seem so bad.
Yeah, it's gotta be good. I mean, Napoleon Bonaparte was there. Would the French people let their boss walk around in stained underwear trying to stab people if the place wasn't nice?
That's why I'm gonna go stay with my mother in Baltimore and work at her wife's bar.
Wait, what? Tori, come back! Damn it!
Wow, shocker. Your gross hookup from the car wash ended poorly?
Stewie, thank God! How'd you find me?
Well, you remember when the vet knocked you out to take out that rotten tooth? He also put a tracking chip in your neck.
What? That's a total violation of my rights!
There you are. Where the hell have you been?
I got arrested for hucking a TV VCR combo off the dam.
Off the dam what?
Off the dam overpass. God, I love you, Lois. That was like great sex. But seriously, it was bad. It hit a school bus.
Oh, my God. What, can you go talk to...
We didn't know what else to do. But you're right. We gotta get him out of there.
You most certainly do. All right, how about that back rub now?
What are you, nuts?
What the hell do you want?
Oh, hello, sir. I'm afraid there's been a mistake. I believe you found our dog, and we...
Hi, are we here to pick up Joe Swanson?
Are you from the news? You have to tell us if you're from the news.
No, we're his friends.
What are you guys doing here?
We came to bring you home, Joe. We're all really sorry we abandoned you.
Yeah, we just kind of got overwhelmed and all freaked out.
But we're your friends, Joe.
I've been hearing that ringing all week. I just thought I was losing my mind from lunatics screaming in my face.
Your mother's a whore!
I told you that in confidence, Gary.
I
it's so great to have you back, Joe.
You seem good as new.
Yeah, it turns out Dr. Hartman's cell phone
said that the first two times we asked.
I know. He spaces out when he's at the computer.
These aren't my kids. And also, this isn't play wrestling. We're actually fighting.
Now, this mattress was expensive, and I'd like to keep it nice for a little while.
Are you serious? We can't do it? For how long?
I don't know. Let's just keep it new for a few weeks.
A few weeks? Come on, you know I'm terrible at waiting for things.
We'll be right back with more Laverne and Shirley.
But I want it now!
I can't believe you. I thought you were this worldly, sophisticated guy, but you're just a fraud, like Moses.
And the Lord's 11th commandment, Moses gets to be first in line at the buffet.
What? Oh, seriously?
I know, you guys, it's so lame, but that's what it says.
Oh, crap. My husband's home early.
Wait a minute, you're married? And he's here? Now?
Yeah, that's him. You've got to get out of here. He's really jealous. I think he's bitter because he never got the credit he deserved for killing Osama bin Laden.
Your husband's a Navy SEAL?
What the hell is going on here? What is this?
Ruff.
You got a dog?
Yeah. I rescued him from the pound.
Ruff. Ruff, ruff, ruff. Well, hey there, buddy. Wow, his nose is super wet. He must be healthy. Oh, and somebody's been rooting in a sardine can. Well, I'm gonna grab a shower.
Great, honey.
Hey, Lois, check out what I found with my metal detector.
Are those purple hearts?
Yeah, some idiot buried like 100 of them in this big lawn under these bone cages.
Peter, I think you desecrated a military graveyard.
Hey, guys, like 4 Jeeps just drove up onto our front yard.
They must be here for the medals.
Maybe. Or it could be because of my I'm gonna barf on the White House blog. Ah, sweet! Huh. Wonder what happens if I turn it on and point them at each other. Oh my God!
Did you also call into a talk show without turning down your radio first?
My word, Brian, you're really improving. We might actually win this thing.
Thanks. You know, I just pretend that tennis ball is Mitch McConnell trying to roll back subsidies on the Affordable Care Act, and I'm like, nope!
Yeah, I don't need to hear your process.
Look, I'm just happy you pushed me, because now I can't wait for that tournament.
I know, it's going to be great. And I already know exactly where I'm going to put that trophy.
So the baby died?
Yeah, the baby died. But look, first place.
Lois, let us out of here!
No way! You like it so much, then you can rot up there with your buddies.
Lois, so help me God, if you don't let us out right this second, I'm going to take a dump on your wedding dress.
You wouldn't dare.
Don't test me. I'll do it. We'll all do it. Quagmire, pull down your pants.
What? I'm not doing that.
You leave my dress alone, Peter.
If it'll get us out of here, I'll make a duty on it.
What, are you nuts?
I've been crowning for 6 hours. Cleveland's pants are off, Lois. Here come mine. This is happening.
Lois, they're not bluffing. Open the door.
I miss Bonnie.
Damn it, Peter. You hold that in. I know you can. You did it on the ferry to Block Island.
Oh, my God. I'm gonna puke.
That's good. Puke on the dress. Puke on the dress.
Ah, damn it.
Hey there. Oh, what are you doing here?
Quagmire, I have a hobby that takes me this way.
Hey, I'm freezing. You got a blanket in there or something?
I got a towel, but it's wet because I'm eating peaches. I lied about the hobby. I was sinning. I'm going to drive away backwards now.
Now, I understand the show was quite different when it started.
Yeah, in the original pilot, I was actually the star. It was called Chris Griffin, Teen Doctor. Sir, I'm afraid I've got some bad news.
Well, it can't be any worse than what's in here.
I ad-libbed that line. I wasn't even supposed to talk. What they didn't know is that I'd been privately doing jokes about the newspaper for years.
Peter, I need you to take Chris and Meg to school. Today's the day I finally kill that squirrel that's been eating our tomatoes.
Try to get like 8 of them this time. I want to make bruschetta.
Oh, can't the kids just walk? You know I like to watch 2 full movies before I go to work.
No, Peter, they can't walk. It's 3 miles.
Fine, I'll take them. But you better keep those goggles, because I'm going to put them to good use tonight. Once the floor is full of sawdust, we can eat peanuts in here. Correct, Quagmire. I'm going in for gender reassignment surgery.
What the hell, Peter? First my dad, now you? Am I doing this to people? Do you guys feel like cutting off your penises?
No, but I can turn it inside out like rolling up a dress sock.
You guys aren't supporting my choice?
Well, what do you expect, Peter? I mean, a sex change operation? Why are you doing this?
I'll tell you why I'm doing all of this. For me. M.E. M.E. I'm doing it for M.E. Ew. I mean, yay.
Oh, hey, Chris. This is Tyler. Don't make this weird now. Oh, what a gentleman.
Chris, could you please get Hannah a thank you basket and schedule her next appointment? I'd like to see her again in 2 weeks.
Of course. Mr. Quagmire can fit in you at 3 o'clock a week from Thursday.
That works.
And you know to fast the night before?
Yep.
And would you like to leave your panties in the fishbowl for a chance to win a free lunch?
Good luck.
When are you going to do that drawing anyway?
Oh, there's no drawing. I just like smelling the bowl.
Hey, where's Chris?
He's over there playing that carnival game.
Step right up. Everybody take a chance on a whack-a-big-a-pussy.
Hey, Tom. Hey, Tom. Hey, Tom. Hey, Tom. Hey, Tom.
This is not what I thought it was.
Oh, my God. Chris is out of control.
I know. Must be all the violence in movies and sex on TV.
Oh.
See, I listen.
I'm actually very hungry.
Nobody's gonna want you if you're fat. You wanna eat? Get up to that bar and earn your keep.
Well, what should I ask for? 500?
You're not worth that much. You're trash. Ask for 2. You know I hit you and whore you out because I love you, right?
Hi there. You want a party? And can I have some of your bread?
Hi, handsome. You can't have my bread, but you can have something of mine that smells like bread.
Okay, let's go.
Just so you know, it takes me a long time.
Hi, are you a straight adult male who likes to eat crepes without people making unwanted assumptions about your private life? Go to discreetcrepe.com, place your order, and within 30 minutes...
Very masculine pizza delivery for Stewie Griffin.
Oh, thank you. Strawberry banana Nutella with raspberry drizzle. Now I just need a guy's butt to eat this off of, and I got myself a night. In any case, Lyle, I'm very proud of you and your progress. You, my friend, are the greatest invention since the Trapper Creeper.
Look, Peter, I'm glad you're thinking about Chris's future, but he's fine. He's a perfectly normal kid.
Are you crazy? Look at him. He's over there intentionally giving himself a nosebleed.
Yay! My nose is finally a woman!
Wow, that was amazing. Hey, just to be clear, I don't really think you're a whore. I just need to say that to, you know, to finish.
Oh, yeah, of course. And obviously, I don't think you're my Uncle Dale.
Good, same page.
No.
All right, left cankle, red. Right muffin top, blue.
Sorry.
Ugh, God, kill me.
There he is, Mr. Former Sex Offender.
But Mom, it's not that big a deal. All I did was finish those creepy classes.
I know, but now your record is clear. You can go back to being a normal boy and put all this behind you.
Hey, Chris, wait till you see the funny thing I had him put on your cake.
Happy 6th birthday, Timmy?
Uh-oh, they must have mixed him up.
Nice crank, you dirty little bastard.
Sorry, I'll take that. Here's your cake. I ate a great deal of it.
Peter, why'd you want me to get us into this prison?
Because, Joe, everyone knows that all prisoners make bootleg wine in their toilet. We are gonna get so wasted. Oh, look, right here. This one's full of Chardonnay.
Peter, I don't think that's...
But it was Chardonnay. The best Chardonnay I'd ever had in my life. The man who made it, Curtis Murder Dog Williams, went on to become one of America's most celebrated vintners.
Hey, Joe here. Peter's lying. He drank pee-pee.
Hurry, take everything, and be quick, or we'll be in bigger trouble than a fat guy at a water park.
Come on, Dad. Let's go on the water slide.
I can't fit. I'm afraid I'll get stuck. I'll just go in the lazy river.
But, Dad...
No, son. This is the life I've chosen.
Playing the maracas. They're so fun. I wonder what's in them. Sand or rice, probably. Maybe it's little shells? Oh, no. What if it's bones? No, bones are too big. But baby bones aren't. No. Nobody would kill a bunch of babies for maracas. How would you kill all those babies anyway? I'd probably put them in a tub. You could kill like 8 at a time that way. Plus, it softens them up so you can get the bones right out. Joe just had a baby. And I got a baby at home. I got a tub.
Peter, you seem off today. Are you thinking about killing infants again?
No. Now you gotta kill them, too. Michael Myers.
If it seemed like he dead, he ain't dead.
Boy, Peter, seems like that obedience school did wonders for Brian.
Oh, yeah, it's great. He'll do anything I tell him to now.
Maybe I should send Bonnie. Oh, my! All right, somebody say something else.
No, you need to know what you did.
I want you to sign my chest. And I want to hock a loogie in your face.
I want you to sign my ass. And I want to hock a loogie in your face.
I want you to autograph my stomach.
Okay, fine, but do me a favor. Don't spit on my friend.
Hey, Brian, why don't you mind your own business?
It gets way up your nose. I want you to resist the urge to levitate off the ground and float towards the pie.
Doesn't seem too hard.
All right, go stand over there.
Oh, no, you don't. No, you can't go in there. No, stay out of there. That's my special area. No, stop. I'm saying no. What kind of pie is this?
Peter, it's making me watch.
Pete's sake, which has caused outrage with a misogynistic comic. Here's a video of some outrage.
Yeah, those boos don't hurt so much because you spent 2 minutes of the last segment applauding a red velvet cake.
And if that's not bad enough, this morning's cartoon is even worse. Let's put that up.
News, there was a hit and run by a drunk driver today at Quahog Park. 2 children are missing.
I was just there.
Come on in. Your family's waiting in here. There are toys and a puppy and food that's not served from warming trays. Come on, you gotta want it. Oh, you gotta do better than that. Okay, I guess you don't want a new family, toys, and a puppy.
He has you dive for rings? Well, this is like that, except it's a pill, and it's not okay if you don't get it.
Ah, damn you!
Come on, you just touched it!
What's all the yelling? Oh my God, Lois, what are you doing?
First there wasn't enough.
Mr. Griffin, do you really think this is an appropriate cartoon to run on Gloria Steinem's half-birthday?
You sound angry.
Did one of your friends get engaged?
You have no idea how offensive you are to women, do you?
What? I love women. I bet I can name more porn stars than you. But don't tell my wife how many porn stars I know. I'll get in a lot of trouble. I know all of them, though. There are people who just started an hour ago, and I know them.
It worked!
Gracias. What are my powers?
Oh, yeah. It's weird. You're, like, really good at painting my living room. Up, up, and get it done by Saturday. We're having a party.
You can't leave him alone.
Come on, it's good to have some alone time. You know, I spent a year alone on a desert island with nothing but a monkey to keep me company.
You're saved, sir. We're gonna get you back to civilization. And how about we bring along your monkey pal?
Okay.
Yeah, we can teach him sign language, and he can tell us stories about what you two did on the island together.
No. Let's not bring the monkey.
I can't dissect this pig, Mr. Kingman. It's against my religion.
Believe me, Neil, it's no thrill for the pig to touch a Jew either.
Hey, kid, get in my van and I'll give you some candy.
No, my mom says I shouldn't.
Hey, kid, get in my van and I'll give you some candy.
Okay.
Specials, but first, I need to tell you, I'm gay.
The hell you are! No waiter of mine is gonna be gay!
He's the only waiter we have.
Lois, our waiter is dead to us. We have to focus all our attention on our hostess now.
I love you, She-Hulk.
All right, son, I'm gonna need those two hams back.
I don't have any hams.
Lift up your shirt, son.
I need an adult!
You're not a shoplifter. You're just a fat kid. Sorry about that, fatty. Hey, Tom, he's just a fat kid. Aren't you fatty? He's just a big...
Jeez, I'm really sorry, Carter. But at least you have your health.
Oh.
You know, this is your fault. You're the one who said I should do it.
Mm-hmm. There's that judginess Babs is always calling me and talking about.
Look, nobody steals from Carter Pewterschmidt. I am going to Africa and get my money back. And you're coming with me.
Africa? We're going to Africa? I wonder if it will change us. But of course, it did change us. I've been working here for 50 years pretending I'm a woman.
Do you ever regret not having children, Mother Bernadette?
Oh, I've had many children. Wow, I really messed up. I haven't felt this bad since I drove by that speed sign.
Well, we figured you'd say no to us, but not to Vice President Joe Biden.
Oh, my God! Mr. Vice President!
First, I want to thank you, Vic, for shooting the guy we said was Osama bin Laden. Second, give these kids their dog back.
Of course, sir. I'm so sorry. Here, take him.
Thank you. You're a great American.
Thanks, Mr. Biden.
No problem. Hey, you guys watch Veep?
No.
Yeah, it's all fake.
Yet we said no. Wow, Karen, nice to meet you. I'm Glenn Quagmire. I didn't know Peter even had a sister.
What are you, ashamed of me, Chin Nuts?
Oh my God, his chin kinda does look like nuts.
Ha ha! I never noticed that!
How could you not notice it? Watch this! I'll punch him in the nuts!
That's sorta clever.
Alright, check it out, Bonnie. This is how we're gonna fool Joe's dad.
Oh my God!
Yeah, looks real, right? I put this pair of pants on the front legs of this horse and strapped Joe to the front with his legs tied behind the horse's neck. And then we put Cinnamon's head up the back of Joe's shirt and simply hid the rest of the horse behind this curtain.
His breath is very moist, Peter.
And to induce movement, I'm going to snap the horse's balls with this dampened kitchen towel.
Ah, oh, my God!
Holy crap, he's out of control!
Does that look real?
Ah! Plan B! Plan B!
I'm so happy you all could make it tonight. We will have many things you will nibble at and not eat. Then I will give you a pizza.
Yeah, that's great. Hey, can we watch that last episode of Winter Summer now?
We will watch together after dinner. In the meantime, feel free to watch Korean pop videos.
What is this, and how can I make the rest of my life about it?
All right, Peter, almost done.
Huh? Eh?
Kinda.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Peter, I don't know about this. It seems like a bad idea.
Look, Lois, Joe is one of my best friends, all right? I'm only doing this to help him. Besides, wait till you hear my Joe voice.
God, I hate being stuck in this chair.
No, Peter, that fights it.
I'm afraid his behavior has been an issue for a while. He's even been bothering students during nap time.
Hey, you up? Guess where I have a crayon.
Stewie, you want to check out the go-kart I used in Days of Thunder?
Yeah, listen, I just found out I'm actually going to be tall, so I'm no longer comfortable hanging out with someone whose teeth are bigger than their fingers.
What? That's barely true.
Yeah, so see you later.
You are making a big mistake, Stewie. Nobody walks away from Tiny Tom Cruise.
Yeah, except for all three of your wives. Okay, I'm shutting this now. Okay, so bye.
There you two are. Sit down and join us.
I can't stay, Mom. Brian's showing me all of his favorite stuff to do.
Getting spooked when the furnace goes on?
We're participating in an autism walk.
Looks like you're doing it right now.
And we may be gone for a while, because after that we're going down to the Civic Center. Michael Ian Black is cocking his eyebrows for 4 hours.
He says the things we don't care to say. Bye!
Man, I'm sick of how much time Chris is spending with Brian.
Probably smooching pickles, because they're a couple of pickle smooches.
Oh, come on. I don't want to have to watch this.
Yeah, that's right. I was the only one who didn't get to meet Biden.
You know what? Screw this. I'm out of here.
Hey, where do you think you're going? You're my dog. You're not going anywhere. Besides, I need you, boy. Now more than ever. I think my wife is cheating on me.
Hey, Tori, it's Brian. I'm getting the Chinese food for us. I think I'm going to order some me-like bang ho. That's not a real thing. I'm talking about sex. All right, I'll be there in 5.
Chris Griffin.
Yay!
Yay! That's right, Chris Griffin, a tubby spaz with a heart full of dreams, gets to feel normal for a night, thanks to the kindness of his peers.
I just see him walking around with his hands down his pants all day, and he's just so fat and weird, so we feel bad.
Yeah, last year we did the burnt up kid, so this was a slam dunk.
Oh my god, they just elected him out of pity, because they think he's mentally challenged.
Kind of like we did with George W. Bush, huh? Right?
I guess, Brian. I don't know. Let's just watch some commercials.